Hi, gorgeous ones. Welcome, welcome. I see we've got some people here, and I'm also broadcasting this live to the business page. So say hi. You can say hi in the Q&A. I can see you.
Hi, gorgeous ones. Welcome, welcome. I see we've got some people here.
Little technical difficulty here. I'm here. Oh, don't you love it? Hi, Lynn. Hi, Teresa. Nice to see you here live. And you can, if you want to go into the Q&A and just say hi, where you're from. And I'm going to just jump straight in today because I got this little hit yesterday. And what I'm doing with these hits that I'm getting, and you may relate to these, is I am answering them. I'm answering the call. So yesterday, I came up with this download and I was just thinking about some people I've talked to, some hand analysis readings I've done recently, and you may be on here, may have had one recently, and how to support them and what is the next step from that life purpose reading. So I've come up with how to embrace your gifts so that you can start a movement, be more magnetic, and make more money as a healer. And I'm going to do a little bit of a PowerPoint here. Don't worry, it's not death by PowerPoint, but I kind of like the visuals of this and I just threw this together. So please excuse me if it doesn't kind of line up. I think it does, but there's lots of kind of information today that you can take away and hopefully implement it straight away in your life, in your business. So I'm going to start that now. Just give me a little second here. Just checking that it's going all well over here. Okay, and there will be some time for Q&A. If you want to jump on, we can bring on video or you can just type it into the box. So I will definitely get to that. So I'm just going to share my screen here with you. So hopefully if you can see that, you can type in, yes, I can see that into the Q&A box. And we are away. So again, I'm just going to put myself over there. Okay. Yeah, beautiful. Thanks, Gigi. Good to see you here. And lots of inspiration from last night. So I've just come off a goddess gathering last night, one of the ones I've done. Haven't done one for a fair while. So this kind of is the perfect moment for this. So let's start. So you are in the right place now, and if you're watching this on the live, welcome. If you are a healer or starting a healing business, and it was really interesting, I'll get to that in a moment, but you are, if you're drawn to start a movement and create community or increase your community, and if you want to have more clients and make more money, you are in the right place. I've designed this just for you. So it's for healers, it's for circle facilitators, goddess gathering holders, workshop trainers and teachers, retreat creatrixes, coaches, and women who are ready to say yes and make their hobby a real business. So you may have just kind of had this idea of what you want to do, but you want to take it to that next step. And specifically for healers, just getting on to my little story before, I had a session with one of my beautiful mentors and we were going over purpose. And I don't know if you've had this realization sometimes, but we kind of resist something that is so, so natural in us. It's a gift. And I'm going to go into those shortly. And I asked her, could you just give me my life purpose title? And I know what my life purpose is. I'm a hand analyst and she is, well, she trained me. And she goes, okay, kind of different. But what came out of that was, and I'll get to that soon, is the big shot businesswoman making a public impact in the healing arts. And for me, that is kind of something that I've pushed away, the healing part, which I know I'm a healer. If you're on here, you are a healer as well, or else you wouldn't be drawn to this. And that's why I kind of created this, to step into that even more and to make it specifically for healers. So who it's not for is someone who isn't interested in embodying their gifts, kind of like pushing them away all the time. It's not for someone who's not open-minded to learning more, and someone who makes excuses for what they truly desire. And there's a reason for that. I'll I'll get to that. And also a perfectionist. I always say excellence is enough. Excellence is enough. There's no such thing as perfection. So we're going to cover today in today's session, and hopefully it'll be kind of like 60 minutes. If we end a little bit earlier, that's fine, but I don't want to go over that. So we're going to cover today about starting a movement, what your gifts are using hand analysis, and let's talk about attraction and money. It's all in the money, honey. So make sure you stay right to the end, because I'm going to give you a copy of these slides for you to refer back to. I just need your email address. And if you've registered, I'll send those out to you if you're live now. And there's also a free invitation. I'm not selling anything today, but there is an invitation if you want to have a session with me. So I'll tell you about that at the end. Okay. So does this sound like you? And I know when I was writing these, I was kind of describing myself. So before, are you scared to really put yourself out there as who you truly are, your authentic self? Do you feel underprepared? You know, everybody else has got, it seems they've got all their ducks in a row, but you don't even know where to start. Perhaps you're already in a business. You've got, you know, it's kind of chugging along quite well, but you're still undervaluing yourself. You know, you might be giving away your services or just not charging enough to make ends meet, really. And maybe you've been struggling and trusting yourself, and you're running around in circles searching for clarity on the next steps. Talking about myself, I don't know if that's you. You can pop it in the chat box if that is you. Or not all of them, just maybe one of them. So that's the real problem. But what happens when you embrace your gifts? This is awesome. So you get to express your life purpose and work in the way that you desire and the way you are designed, because we're all unique, yet we're all the same, but we all have this uniqueness, and one size does not fit all. You get really paid well for your goddess-given gifts, and you can start a ripple effect, an important change for your clients and their clients' lives through your unique message. And even though sometimes we go outside and we see other people, came up last night in the group, everybody else is doing it. I mean, I've been guilty of that. So, oh, I don't want to do that. Everybody else is doing it. But you are unique. And what I forgot is I do it in a different way to somebody else. And that is your gift. So just to one of my clients, Britta Morrison. So she trained as a goddess purpose facilitator. She runs several events of her own. She massively expanded her network, received confirmation on her purpose, and seen the beautiful flow and effects that she models for her daughter. And she gets to express her purpose and work in the way that she's designed for. I love Britta. She's amazing. Some of you on here may know her. So just a little bit about me before we jump in. I always get a bit funny about saying this because kind of repeating myself, but I'll give you the very quick version. So I self-appointed myself the chief goddess at Goddess on Purpose, not the chief goddess of all goddesses, global goddess gatherer and divine business mentor. So I'm an author, an international speaker, a master hand analyst and trainer, business mentor and coach. Healer, I'm really bringing in that word healer, spiritual teacher, and the best job of all, I am a mum. So I help women around the globe get their lives and businesses on purpose through embodying pleasure, power, and prosperity. And I do this by identifying the number one thing holding them back and help them turn it into their biggest strength so they can express their feminine essence and enjoy a juicy, abundant life. So I don't know if you can tell by my accent, but I am from the land of the long white cloud, Maori heritage, in fact, and moved over. I think I've been in Australia now for 20-something years, close to 25 years. So I made the move over. And I've done a lot of jobs. I don't know if you can relate to this. Lots of different things. I'm a generator by human design. So generators normally we're kind of like the workhorses. So I'm not afraid of work in any sense of the word. So I've been a casino dealer. I've been a bookkeeper, real estate agent, and I even owned my own fish and chips shop in New Zealand for about a year. So I knew I was quite entrepreneurial. I would try lots of different things, and kind of all leads up to where I am today. The big thing for me was when I was 25, I discovered I had a brain tumor, a tumor on my pituitary gland. And it was quite a shock. I was, I think I was 25 at the time, healthy as anything, in a casino job. And it kind of woke me up a little bit, well, quite a lot, actually. So this is not me in these photos, but this is actually what I went through every day for 3 weeks. I went down to, I think it was St. Kilda, some hospital in St. Kilda. So I don't even remember, it was that long ago. But if that tumor kept growing, it was benign, I would eventually go blind. And that kind of got me to a point of asking the question, what am I really here to do? Why is this tumor here? I was not spiritual at all, did not even, my sister was, she was doing Reiki and doing some cards and things like that. And I just went, oh, please, please. But when this happened to me, I kind of knew something was up. So I started to investigate this spiritual realm, or the reason why I had this tumor. And growing up in New Zealand, being a Maori woman, we are to be seen and not heard. And I kind of, and this is all unconscious. So I kind of felt my voice was taken away, and it's around this area, right? The tumor. So I did get this radiotherapy done. I didn't know any other kinds of healing. And the good thing about it was it would shrink it, but the bad thing about it was that it could kill all the cells around and I could eventually not have children. So that was kind of the risk I had at that time. 25, wasn't really maternal, kind of wanted to see, kind of use my eyesight, and I just went for it. But I am a high achiever, and I did end up with two beautiful children that are kind of, my guiding light, both of them, and this goddess work that I do and purpose work, especially to be that example for my daughter and my son, because he's going to marry somebody beautiful one day, inside and out. So they kind of, when I get down in moments of, just being mean to myself, I remember them and the gift that they really are. So that was me. I found this quote on my journey, and I started doing Reiki and I could NLP, neurolinguistic programming, all these kind of things to kind of make myself a better person, or just to find my purpose. And this quote came up, and Marianne Williamson, and I start everything with this. If I have a little moment, I'll always remember this quote. So I'm just going to read it out to you. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us. We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, and fabulous? And actually, who are you not to be? So I just want you to take that in for a moment. Who are you not to be? And that's kind of my inspiration and why I started my movement here. So I'm just making sure. Okay, beautiful. And I just love this quote here. It's, I just missed it. You need to have money on your mind, but impact drives income, not the other way around. So even though, and especially in this healing world, there's just kind of some blocks sometimes, not everybody, about money and receiving that. And oh, if you go after the money, you're a bad person, or money doesn't bring happiness, that kind of stuff. But it's not about the money. It's about your impact. And once you get your impact and your message and your movement and you're on purpose, the money comes in. So I love that quote. So just a few little pickies of my journey. I started being a hand analyst over 7 years ago now, and read some books, created my own oracle card, trained women in goddess facilitated training, and now hand analysis, and just spreading my message. It was all going really, really well until I kind of had a bit of a, not a breakdown, I just broke up my marriage, actually. So let's be honest. So that ended, and I had to start to go in. I had to go in and just see, what's the next step for me? So I think we've all had these different points in our lives. It could be divorce, it could be health challenges. There's always that little knock on your shoulder, right? I hope you can relate to that. So this was me then, and still is. But I took it upon myself when I found out my life purpose to build community through live events. And it was kind of like, oh, I'm going to out all the healers. So I have a lot of healing friends. And I noticed that because I had some background in business and another business, it's kind of like, oh, if you just applied these principles to your healing business, it would be so much better. And to come about outing them, you know, healers are here to change the world. And I'm saying that to myself as I'm sharing that with you, but we really, really are. And if we can just get to the point where we don't have shame about certain things and we're not scared about certain things and we take that risk and be in the joy of it. So some events there, goddess gathering, speaking and hand analysis. So that's kind of where I've come from. But it wasn't always like this. You know, I was always changing jobs and starting careers and never really followed through with a lot of them. I mean, those four that I showed you was just the tip of the iceberg. I also resisted doing coaching for a long time. There was something about it, and now that I've had my hands out, I know what my design is. I get it. But I just thought, you know, I make people feel good and did it for free. Didn't think I could turn it into a business. And I had a real desire to do my life's purpose if I could only have clarity around it. I also saw how others were doing their work. And as I started on that journey, I made a few mistakes. I said few, but I actually made lots of mistakes along the way, until I learned how to make them much more successful. So it is kind of trial and error some of the times, but you can shortcut that, definitely. And that's when I realized I wasn't expressing my true gifts as my purpose. So first you've got to identify them, and then you've got to do work on them and put them together. So I started out with just doing workshops in women's homes. They were called goddess play shops, and we'd have some beautiful oils, and it wasn't party plan as such. It was actually teaching and building, giving them an experience. But I would go out to people's homes and didn't think of doing them at my own until later. So, and then I just started hosting my own workshops at home, goddess gatherings, I called them. And it just started because I wanted community. I was kind of out on my own. I had some friends who were healers and I just went, oh my gosh, if I pulled everybody together and gave a spot to a friend who could share one of her gifts with us, and then I just contained the space, didn't really know what I was doing, but I thought, that would be so much fun. And it started with 11 goddesses in this, we called it the goddess shed, in this space. We had, I'm actually in my lounge room now, and we had six women here last night, six here, and it was beautiful. So it was kind of like, it doesn't matter the size of it. But it ended up having 3-day events, 3 years in a row, up to 130 women from all over. And I did it from an email list of about 800, which kind of blew my coach's mind, my mentor's mind. She said, how did you do that? I went, I don't know, I just did it. I did know. I've kind of worked the formula out now, but I went, I don't know, because you're supposed to do that from a list of 8,000. Oh, God, there's a fly in here. Of 8,000, not 800. So now I've inspired other healers to put their work into the world and for them to have this huge network of support. So I hope that was a short version. Now to the good stuff. So just let me ask you a question. When is now a great time to learn the right way to express your gifts in your healing business? Hopefully you're saying now. And maybe you've already, you know, invested in a small way or big that you can make your movement. I love the word movement. And how big is your desire to live by your unique design? And I don't know if you've got some pen and paper beside you, but you might want to take notes here. Take the gems that speak to you. So let's dive in. Five steps I'm going to go over and... not too quickly, but these are the five things that I just went, what can I share today? And it's, what is your movement about? It's two, showing up as you, honoring your purpose and gifts. Four is doing the inner work and being witnessed in that. And five is the money, honey. So let's go. So my question to you is, what is your movement, or how do you start a movement? And it comes back to a bit to your why. Like, why, or your purpose? What is your purpose? Why are you doing the things that you want to do? What's your heart saying to you? And for me, it was, when I started these goddess gatherings, I didn't think of it as a movement. I just wanted women to come together. And it was purely for my own reasons. But then I started seeing the magic that happened in that. And I went, oh, there's a movement happening here. Right. So, and the movement is, for me, is bringing women together, inspiring each other to live their own purpose, and inspiring them to, and whether that's in a business or whether it's in their family, it doesn't matter. It wasn't about just going into business. It was inspiring them to be who they are and to come in, relax, be witnessed, have some fun and talk. Of course, women love to talk and just chat, but I would always have a theme. And the movement that I created is spread really, really big. And I don't mean to say that to make myself feel, blow myself out, but sometimes when I did all my Goddess on Purpose trainings, there was a night, every Friday I would have these goddess gatherings. And because I trained other women, I knew at that time when I had my goddess gathering, there were like 20 other women having their own, all scattered all over Australia and some even overseas. And I just went, wow, that's a beautiful web of this magic. And they're all doing it with their own flavor. They weren't copying me. There was a structure set out, but their own essence. And that's the magnetism of people, why they will go to you, because it's like, So that was kind of my movement. Some other movements that I started was down here on the right, I've got the Celebration Revolution. And again, just an idea. And for me, I know a lot of healers have trouble showing up or being seen. It's a big thing. And back then, before the days of live video or live Facebook Live, I started doing videos and really enjoyed them. It was so old-fashioned, you'd have to upload it and put it on and it would take hours. This now you go straight to Facebook Live. But the Celebration Revolution was really an idea of mine, or and a movement for people to come on, and every day they had to share something that we're going to celebrate about. Could be they got the job, could be they spoke their truth, anything. But the actual rules around that was they had to do it on video. I didn't want them just to go in and type it, you know, very easy to do and still be hidden. So I didn't tell them that was my ulterior motive, but it really was. I wanted them to show up and to be authentic. And it's really easy. So, you know, the question was, celebrate something, and it was really easy. So that was, I think we got about 130 people in there, did it for 30 days and went on, rolled on to another 30 days. But that was kind of the movement I created. And so when I'm saying this to you, think of them, what, you know, something might be dropping down into to for you. What is my movement? What do I want to inspire people for? Or what is your bigger why? Okay, so, and this is, it comes back to me. I love just gathering people. I love inspiring them. That's kind of the movement. Over the left here, this is actually current, actually. We're doing this now. And I went, okay, I've done the Celebration Revolution. And, you know, I love challenges myself. I don't know about you. But the 30-day check-in challenge is every day for 30 days, we've got people just checking in how they're feeling. And that's it. And it's not a video challenge. I didn't want to stretch it that far. But really, again, I've created this movement of women checking in with other women and being seen and sharing. And they're sharing three things. And some of them, and it's not all roses, right? Some of them are sharing, oh, I'm not feeling great today, blah, blah, blah. But nobody else is coming to rescue them. It's actually just about putting it in this group. That's safe. So that's kind of the movement there. And of course, in business, there's all these little taps that you can make for people, right? So maybe they'll come into your Celebration Revolution. Maybe they'll come to the Check-In Challenge and they'll go, wow, I really like this. What else has she got? or what else have you got to offer? So think about your movement. And please, you know, if you've got any chats or anything there, please just type them in. I'm going to check them soon. So how do I get that going? Go away. I don't know. Oops. Okay. So our second part is actually showing up as you. And did you like my goddess cup? How cool is that? Very old, these goddess cups. So this is kind of this picture here is in the Goddess Shed. We're doing some goddess facilitated training here. And I don't know what I was doing at that stage, but maybe teaching them something. But knowing me before, kind of like 10, 15 years ago, I was very shy and I was not this person in front of hundreds of people or even in front of four people speaking my truth. And it takes a lot of work, and that's kind of one of the next points. So doing that inner work of that, but showing up as you. And I remember doing my goddess play shops, and they were so lovely and I loved them so much. And they were beautiful, very, for me now, for the work that I do, quite light. And that was because 7 years ago, the word goddess, people were like, or women were like, I don't know about that goddess stuff. And now it's quite, you know, everyone's embracing it. Everyone's going, yes, I am a goddess, which I love. But back then, we would have these beautiful oils that I put on, actually. Well, you can't see me here. These beautiful oils, and we'd teach about chakras and, you know, do beautiful affirmations. And that was kind of it, because that was the level that I was at then, right? Just showing up as me. And what happened as I did more work on myself, there was deeper stuff. And as I got my purpose identified, I knew I had to go deeper. So my retreats and things like that are a lot different now. I'm just going to check these chats. Oh, okay. Cool, Lindy. Gigi, I'm going to get to that. I'll get to you. Thank you so much. So showing up as me, we all have this little mask, right? We all do. And I knew I still had this mask on. And the inner work that it took, which was being around other women, doing different courses and really getting to the core of who I am. It's so, so boring not showing up as myself anymore. You know, there's this little bit of edginess to me sometimes, but then there's also this gentleness. So they kind of both come together, and I'll pick and choose where I am, but I'll never hide one for the other. Hopefully, right? So showing up as authentically you. Now, if you are quite shy or an introvert, that is fine. You just create your business around that, you know, because you probably attract other shy people who need your work to open up, perhaps. And I'm not too sure what kind of businesses you're running, and we can get to that soon, but be authentic as you. If you're loud and out there and you're trying to shut yourself down so you fit in, don't be that woman, because energetically we feel it. It's like something's just off, you know. And you probably, you know, that, you know, when someone's like, oh, that's not really them, but they're trying to fit in. So show up as authentically as you, warts and all, right? Warts and all, because that is when you get the real connection with people. Get off my soapbox. Right. Number three is to, I'm just trying to get rid of, I don't know if you can see, anyway. Number three is to honor your purpose and your gifts. So there are many ways to identify your gifts. This is a photo of me, 2012, I think. I was preparing for one of our Goddess on Purpose events. All the hands were coming in and in our office there. And knowing your gifts, you can find it in many different ways, right? Numerology, human design, astrology, hand analysis, lots of different things. And this is just my modality that I use and I've mastered, and I love it, and it's very simple. So, but it is in the interpretation of what's in your hands. And so for healers, one little thing I'm just going to get off here is that sometimes I will lead with their modality. I'm a Reiki healer. But that's not really what the other person wants. They just want to feel good. They want to clear something out. And so you don't have to lead with that. I'll kind of come full circle to that, if you know what I mean. So I'll get on with this part. So honoring your purpose and your gifts. And so I'm using hand analysis. So what is hand analysis? It's a direct path to your life purpose. So it's scientific hand analysis, a combination of palmistry and the latest scientific discoveries. And it's non-predictive. So your life purpose, just showing the camera, is in your fingerprints, your soul's purpose, your life purpose, your life lesson, and your life school. And it's non-predictive. So again, it's a system that anybody can learn. The gift markings are lines or formations on the hands, and not every line's a gift marking, but it represents extra potential talent. So if you have one, it's a big deal. If you have more than one, it's a super big deal. And I do attract people with a lot of gift markings because I have a lot as well. I'm bringing this into the bigger picture for you. About approximately 10% of the general population has some type of gift marking because you're not born with them. They just show up later on. You come in with your purpose, nice and pure. Children are not really born with them, although maybe some are now given the times that we're in. And if you have multiple gift markings, you're kind of in 1%. So that they are quite rare. So when they show up, it means you have to use it. Otherwise, you have to deal with kind of the student path or the, you know, the little taps on the shoulder because they want to be used. And for people who don't have gift markings, it's not you're not gifted. It just means you don't have to deal with the tap on the shoulder. So knowing all of these things is so important. So, okay. So I'm going to go to, for those who I've said it's really paramount. So it is. So finding your design and your uniqueness is the map, okay? Whether it's this or another system, totally, you can go to another system, it's fine. But get to the uniqueness of you. Now, for instance, this is my purpose, the big shot businesswoman making a public impact in the healing arts, which means, you know, I can help women. Well, not just women, anybody who specifically who are in the healings, like who are trying to run business, healing businesses. And the big shot comes because it's the successful visionary, you know, the entrepreneur. That's where that part comes in. And the public impact means in the spotlight. It's not sitting behind, it's not just doing the kind of the one-on-ones all the time. You can do that, but it's to the masses. So that's my design. That's my purpose according to my fingerprints only, right? So that's the first part. And when I learned about this, again, 7 years ago, nearly 10 years ago now, I just started crying because, you know, what was I doing before? The casino dealer, the fish and chip owner, the real estate person, when really all paths were leading to my purpose. My soul wanted to do my purpose. And, you know, what I want to say too is your life purpose is lifelong, okay? And you can express it in a business. You don't have to, but why wouldn't we? So that's my purpose. And then my lesson, which is so, so important, and this was kind of shown again to me the other day, is not trusting my intuition and having a crisis of meaning. So what that means is, and all along it has been second guessing myself. I'll be speaking to somebody before I embrace this gift and I would just know stuff but I'd hold that to myself. I would hold that if I'd actually shared that as a healer, it might've actually helped them on their path. You know, they would have found it another way, but they're in front of you for a reason. So I felt like I was holding back this intuition of mine. And the crisis of meaning, when you hold back the lesson, when you hold back all this intuition, you kind of go into this crisis of meaning. What's it all for? The dark night of the soul, because you are pushing away something that comes so naturally to you. And the point of the lessons, I'm just looking at the time here, the point of the lessons is to embrace them. So by flipping that around and putting that into your purpose. So I hope you're getting this. I know I'm School of Service. I'm giving a lot of information. Please stop me if you're going, it's too much, take notes. The way to flip that, not trusting my intuition, means that I have to totally work to trust myself, trust what comes in for me, and help and flip that away and teach others how to trust their intuition. Does that make sense? Because I know what it feels like to push it away and the trouble and the pain it is as I go into my crisis of meaning, finding out what's my career now, what am I supposed to do? That's that kind of little spiral that I go down to. And I still do every now and again, but now I've got my map. It's like, oh, where am I? Where do I need to step up? How do I need to show up more? So the crisis of meaning, and I help actually people with crisis of meaning. So I hope that makes sense. So that's one part of it. Oh. The next part is the gift markings. So there are 18 kinds of gift markings. I'm going to just share quickly what they mean, not the 18 of them. But in my hands, I have these three. I have different ones, but I'm going to work with these three because it kind of brings into the healing, my purpose of the healer. So the Neptune stars means I'm an empath. I'm just going to go through one thing because there's lots of information on all this. I'm an empath. I know stuff. I can help people transition. And that's part of my purpose. So I've got my business healer making a public impact. Add in the empath, right? If I'm not using those gifts or recognizing them, I get stuck in sadness. That's what happens. I go down into this little hole, which is I feel sad for no apparent reason because I'm not sharing that gift. The Apollo star means if you have one of these, it means you have fame and fortune in the spotlight. And I get a few of my clients have had this. And it's like, oh, really? I went, really? So when I'm talking to them and they're rejecting that part of themselves, I know that just there's a resistance there. And sometimes when we talk about it, the fame and fortune in the spotlight is fame. What does fame mean for you? Oh, I'm going to be like one of those Hollywood stars and, you know, they make all this money or they get famous and then, you know, they go into this really awful place of depression or, you know, suicide or things like that. Heaven forbid, that's not you. But really it means that when you step into you and share your message and start your movement, the fame will come and will support your movement and the fortune will come with that as well. So stepping in and claiming your spotlight versus the fear of rejection. So if you're working, if you have one of these in your hands and you are just not showing up because you're scared of rejection, it's kind of like in the movies, right? They used to have somebody would be on stage and then there'd be this big hook that would hook you off because you're not enough. Or you said the wrong thing. That's that fear. And it's an internal thing. I mean, this is one of my, these are my gift markings. So I do feel that's like, damn, am I going to show up on Facebook Live today? Or what am I going to say? Or is it good enough? And then I go, oh, you're just in the student path of that where my soul wants to go, yes, show up. Who knows who's going to see your message? Don't be attached to the outcome of it. Just show up and share. And the last one of mine is Pluto stars. So Pluto stars, they mean radical transformation. Radical. So what that means is that when you come to me as a healer or a coach or a mentor, it's going to be pretty radical. And I don't mean it's going to hurt, but it might feel like that sometimes because it's kind of ripping that Band-Aid off as quick as you can. But you wouldn't appear with me if you weren't ready for that. That's what I mean. So, and it means you have to delve into the depths, you know, to the shadow, which I'm all for. I'm all for now. Before, when I was doing Goddess Play Shops, not so much. So now it's like radical transformation, clear it out and start again. Now, if I'm not doing that, I get stuck in the dark. I just go, oh, and it's, you know, it's not nice being in the dark and I get really resistant to change. So you may be thinking, oh God, have I got these in my hands? Or I mean, you'll know if this is you. So bringing that all together, knowing my design, I know I'm a businesswoman, healer, making an impact, helping through people, through transformation. And the more that I'm out there, the more the fortune will come, Right. Just for me, it's just I cannot hide away, even though there's part of me that is a huge introvert, huge introvert. So I'll come out when I need to, when I'm inspired, and then I'll just go back and, you know, regroup myself. But really, my soul wants to do this. So knowing that, you can see how important it is when I know the student path, when I'm on the student path. So number four is do your inner work. So if people skimp on their inner work, their outer work will suffer as well. It's kind of like, brings, you know, it's like, what's the metaphor of a car? How you treat your car, and please, it's not a great metaphor for me because it's not working for me today, but, you know, if you have your car and it's all messy on the inside, it's kind of a reflection of what's going on here, you know, all this clutter up here. So you've got a clean car out there, but it's just do your inner work, clean the car. It's not hard to do. So you must do your inner work, right? And some of the inner work is you can do that as easily. It's not hard. It's you can join a women's circle or a spiritual circle. Of course, I'm talking to healers here. So it's to, there's deep inner work and embracing your shadow side. You know, it's not all love and light. It's not. We have to see the appreciate the shadow to know the light. So knowing these parts of ourselves that we push away. The inner work is dealing with our money issues, right? Our money issues, it's like, ugh, I want to just stick my thing, get down my throat. It's because we all have them, or we're all working through them. So deal with them, work through them, acknowledge them. A big thing is to own your value. And owning the value, big one for me too, is kind of like don't undervalue yourself, right? Don't give away things. And a lot of healers do this barter system. I've done it before, and then do it to, as long as you have the agreement in place. But in the past, like, oh, I'll give you a massage if you give me a Reiki session. It's like, well, as much as I'd love to, I can't pay my rent with your massage. So there's a difference in owning your value, and maybe you've got something that's more, worth more than what they've got to barter with. So just do the exchange correctly, right? Just do the exchange correctly. And I know I'm saying this, and it's taken different practices to get where I am today. So it's kind of like do that work. So again, designing your own regular practices. I have a few things that I do each day that just put me in that right space. And I know when I'm off because I've missed something, you know, and even if I miss a day, I'm not hard on myself. So, oh, okay, I need to get back in there. And then things start to flow much better. A big thing is to be witnessed and appreciated. And this is a beautiful work of Rachel Jane Groover of the Art of Feminine Presence. And when I did her teacher training, the witnessing was just phenomenal, and the appreciation, and I put it into my work now as a licensed teacher, but the appreciation of another woman and you receiving that can kind of gauge where you're at actually. You know, in the past when people say, oh, I love your dress, and you're like, oh yeah, I just got it from the op shop or something. It's like, oh, why did she tell me that? I'm just saying that I loved her dress. Or, oh my God, you look fabulous today. And it's like, oh, you look fabulous too. So it's an instant throwback to the other person, right? But when we teach these appreciations, it's like, let it come in. And I like to add, so you can actually take, this could be one of your practices. If somebody gives you a compliment, just sit there and just say, thank you. It's true. And see what happens. Like, send me an email. I just want you to get into the pressure. Thank you. It's true. Just receive it. So, and being witness in our celebrations and being witness in our struggles. You know, if you see another woman and she's going through that, and you're kind of going through it the same, it's just something that happens magically to move you forward. So, and the last one, get a coach, get a mentor, or get a guide. And it's probably something that really flipped things me or quickened things up. I've always had a mentor, a personal mentor, and a business mentor. And sometimes they're the same, sometimes they're not. You know, you would, if you want to go and train for a triathlon, you would go and get a coach to help you do that. And for some reason in this healing world, it's kind of weird. It's like, oh, you know, I'll try and do this by myself, when you could just cut years off it to master who you are and master your purpose. So definitely do that. I'm just looking at the time here. Okay, so making more money. Do you love that spiral? I love it. It's kind of like the koru in New Zealand, the fern. So how to make more money, which is actually number five. Making more money means charging what you're worth. What? Charging what you're worth. And having that sounding board. So if you think your sessions or your, actually, and a good thing is, like, stop just doing the one-offs. You know, if you're doing one Reiki session, for instance, what would be a really good thing to do is sell a package, like do three at a time, and or put all your work into a program. I'm kind of getting off here, but that's kind of what I do, is help people make their programs. So you might have $1,000 program. What's the natural progression for somebody to work for you? What's the transformation that you give them? And charge what you're worth. Heal your relationship with money. And we all have a certain relationship with money. We kind of come in with that. And over time, our parents and people around us. So just heal it. Like, be conscious about it. There's lots of courses out there you can do. And just, you know, healing that worthiness. A big thing for healers, and for me, it was like, oh my God, I don't want to sell. I don't want to sell anything. I'll probably come off creepy or, you know, demanding or wanting, and it's kind of yucky. And all you need to do is to reframe that word to share, right? Sharing, share, not selling. I'm okay with it now, but once you get really solid in your value, again, your value, what you're worth, and also make it about the other person. Because sometimes we're doing this amazing presentation or work with somebody, or, you know, making an offer, and we come to that selling bit, and then all of a sudden this throat chakra just chokes up, right? It's like, and they'll go, how much, like, what have you got to offer? On the other side, they're just going, hurry up, tell me, how do I work with you, because you've done such a great job. But when it gets to the selling point, we kind of blow it sometimes. I've blown lots of it, and until I actually realize it's not about me, I'm sharing my gifts, and I'm going to make, you know, profound change in their lives, right, if I actually get them to take me up on that offer. So it's all about sharing, share. And making offers, okay, so that's a big thing. We one of the things in my goddess gatherings, because I love to inspire other women to share their gifts, is I actually give them a space at the end of the evening that if they've got workshops or if they've got services, they have, you know, a minute to share what they've got going on. And some of them have walked away and later on contacted me and gone, oh, thanks for doing that, but I didn't have anything to offer. I didn't know what to say. So make sure you do have your offers in place, right? Make sure you do have something to sell. Share. And the next one, promote yourself unashamedly. And we talked about last night was the shame hangover. And sometimes we kind of put ourselves out there. For women, it seems to be a little bit harder. I don't know why, but it's just the way we're wired. So we've got a little bit of rewiring to do about that. You know, you'll see men, yes, here's my offer, boom, 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 it's out there. They're doing this and this and this, and they're not ashamed about it. But for some reason, we kind of get, oh, I know, is it too much? Am I too icky? And on Facebook, I will put anything up that I want to share, right? I'm in the moment and I'm coming from this inspired place. But sometimes even I go, oh, was that too much? And then I'll go, well, actually, no. When somebody's booked in or they've just contacted me about it, it's like the perfect time that you've shared. So promote yourselves at networking events. Like, be in a place where you can share your offers with others. Because who are you not to be that? Right? Going back to the Marianne Williamson, who are you not to be? And when you get all these in line, abundance is flow. How cool is that? And just kind of works, and trusting yourself. So they are the five things. So when you own your purpose, embody your gifts, show up as you, engage in your why, start your movement, then everything else flows. It really, really does. And I know you've had moments of these where something's worked and you've owned certain things and you might not have been conscious about it, but it's like, oh, wow. If you go back and look at that moment in time, you'll see, oh, that's what worked for me. So just let's recap on the five steps. So I went through what is a movement, how to show up as you, honoring your purpose and your gifts, doing your inner work and getting witness with that, and making more money. So I'm going to open, if you've got any questions here, I don't think I've got anything. So we started, how to start your movement, the way to your purpose, key to change your money mindset and flow. Well, why are you doing that? So just do this. And just going back to that real problem, right? You sometimes the real problem is you're watching all that noise out there and getting disheartened. Social media, the emails, TV, it's all around us. And we're like, who am I to be that person? Someone else has done it. You know what I said about that. You know what, that you have a purpose and are gifted, but what's next, right? So the people who I work with, yes, maybe you've had a hand analysis from me. It's like, got it. What's the next step? Okay, because once you know, you can never unknow. And that feels you, if you're not doing that, it feels you feeling depressed, exhausted, undervalued, and resentful. And you don't want to be that person. So I hope you're getting this one thing. You're not meant to be here to struggle and to put your healing work out in the world. You can absolutely step into who you really are if you really want this and have that desire. There can be no more apologizing. And I love that word. Just be unapologetic in who you are, right? In who you are. And it's not about it's not about what you are doing. It's not that specific modality or I don't know, whatever it is you're doing, but it's actually who you are being. What does your soul want to be expressed today as? So I'm going to take some questions after this, but I just want to share this. The next steps, if you're ready to take that next step, then it's time for a Power Up Your Purpose session with me. Don't you love it? That just came through this morning too. What am I going to call these sessions? Power Up Your Purpose. And if I could show you which of these steps you're missing, would you be interested? If I could identify your gifts, would you be interested? If you could talk to me and I can help you get back into flow and hold up the mirror that is blocking you, would you be interested? So introducing the Power Up Your Purpose session. So come down that walk there on the red carpet and you can book in your free 30-minute consultation with me. And I know that's a pretty interesting link there, but I'm going to put it below and I'm going to send out an email as well. And I'll put it in the chat. But it's http://smpl.ro/power. So that's the session. I'm going to get on the phone with you, a Zoom call actually, and let's flesh it out. Which one of these steps are you missing? What do you need support in right now? So I do want more for you, so much more, but the question is to you. Now, that's the question you have to ask yourself. And I know if you're watching this, of course you do. Of course you do. You want to start this movement. You want to be more abundant in sharing your gifts with the world. So that is the link there. I'm going to put it in there. So as I'm closing up, and I am going to take some questions. If you have them, you can type them in or you can come on. If you want a hot seat, I'm happy to do a hot seat here. The world will be saved by the Western women. We are so, the Dalai Lama, you know, we have the resources around us to make and be the change, so be the change. And we are so lucky in these Western countries. You know, we are so lucky. So it's kind of, it's up to us to make that change. One person by one person. All right, it can be that simple. So I've got some people here that I've worked with before. Jackie, who's a psychologist, and I'm just going to go through these. And Carrie, who's a naturopath, and then beautiful Margaret, who runs your own retreats and goddess gatherings. And all three of these make such an impact in their communities and with their message, all different messages, but essentially they're just, you know, that they are healing other people. So you can go to this page. I'm going to stop my share now and open it. I'm going to stop my share. Stop share. Okay. So are there any questions? And I'm just going to find my link here and put it in here in the chat that you have, or any aha moments, actually, any aha moments that you might have here at all. Okay, let's close that. Okay, so Gigi, you're saying, I am still unsure of my why, and because of my offerings, a little unsure. What I mean is that I'm unsure where they are leading. Just a little bit unsure, not totally. So, Gigi, do you want to expand on that? It's unsure of the why, and maybe there's, if you could actually, do you want to come on, Gigi? I don't know. Put you on. No, okay, she doesn't want to come on. So can you just expand a little bit on that? And maybe, and this is the thing, if you are not clear of your why, most people feels like, oh God, it feels like it's just resistance, and perhaps it's too big, and perhaps it's kind of like they're playing small or they're playing safe. Now, and I'm not saying that you're doing that, Gigi, and I know we've worked together before, but oh yeah, and still are. So it's great. I love that you, it's ownership. And Gigi runs these beautiful Fika events, and she's all about building this, her community. And she also does this, these amazing web designs. So it's kind of pulling in your packages and coming out in a bigger way for your, like, I just love your Fika. When you talk about your Fika events, then you just light up. I mean, that's my experience of you and the way that you bring them in. And it's kind of, okay, what's the next step from that? What's the next step from that? And what kind of movement do you want to start? So I don't know if that actually answered your question or just gave you more questions. So we've got that. Oh, hello. Hi, Aisha. I have my purpose for my session, but I don't know how to manifest this in a business, and I can't tap into my why because I'm exhausted. And don't we want to be of service to others right now? Of course, I get it. I totally get it. And this is a thing probably, okay, so what we have our purpose, your purpose, and it's massive. All of our purposes feel very massive. And I think if they don't feel to so many others before, that now it is your time. It is your time to go into the cocoon, and not the total cocoon. It's just like, what's next? Like to start, let whatever's going to bubble up for you, right? Because you have your purpose as your fingerprints and those beautiful gift markings. And it's kind of like, for you, it might be just, where is my movement in this? So for instance, if you have a Persephone line, and I'm totally talking hand analysis now, which you may or may not have, that is about guiding lost souls, right? And having and owning that you are the queen and owning that you have this beautiful energy to do that. And sometimes if you're pushing against that, it can feel like being trapped, which I don't know if you have in the past or you're out of that now. And so you might, for instance, want to help other women or other people guide other people so they can expand themselves, so they don't feel trapped anymore. And I'm not going into specifics here, but it's kind of along that line and working with what was my biggest, I mean, we all have things in our lives that we, moments, you know, that are our dark night of the soul. And my belief is that they are put there to shake us up. But also this part of that story, like everyone has their story, that they're here to share with others. And that's massive because it means being vulnerable and sharing some of it. And you don't have to go spew it all out on everybody. It's just get the gems from that and look at that. So I look at my tumor, for instance, and I go, oh, what I was like at that point, I wasn't in touch with my spiritual side. I was always searching for something. And this whole, this coaching and mentor side of me, it was happening naturally. I was telling people in my business with my ex-husband, leave here. This is not your purpose. So I had to kind of find myself from there because it wasn't the right place to share my gifts. So I hope that's sort of something. Oh, thank you. Great, Aisha. I know it rambled on a bit there, but yeah, step by step and identifying your gifts and working with one each week, perhaps. You know, it's like, oh, I'm going to dive into, for me, it's the empath, right? I'm going to dive into what transition means for me, or I'm just going to let myself be held in. Like one time somebody said to me, just let yourself have the grief. I was blocking something so fully. I'm like, no, I'm going to soldier on. And she said, just let yourself have the grief. And I went, okay. And I let myself, and that's the empath, feel what I needed to feel. And I came up and I was good again, but I needed to go through that. So I know we're 1 minute past. Is there anybody else who has any questions that I can answer, or you can email me at luann@goddessonpurpose.com. Yes, there's no way, .com. So yeah, I hope this has been really helpful for you. So again, all those five things. If you want a session with me, I've put it into the chat box above there. And yeah, I'll send this out as an email as well. And if you need the slides, just email me also. I'm not going to send them out to everybody, but just send me an email. Send me the slides, please. And I'll send you this recording. So it's luann@goddessonpurpose.com. So that's it, beautiful ones. Thank you for joining me on this Friday. I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful weekend and something sinks in and you'll come up with your movement. Many blessings. Bye for now.